Weekly Outdoor Plus is a new and exciting outdoor show presented by Bucks and Bulls Archery in Stevens Point, starring new owner Gary Hintz. His youngest son, the show pro, Jace Hintz. And the show producer, creator, and host, his oldest son, Seth Hintz. So now sit back and relax and get ready to learn about archery and the world of the outdoors.
So it's October 10th. It was my first day out hunting in Wisconsin, and I actually shot a doe the first day. We were only out for about an hour and a half-ish, so we're just looking at the blood trail, and we're gonna go and recover, hopefully.
Stay tuned to see what it takes for Jordan to take down a Wisconsin white-tailed doe in this year's early archery season, coming up after this quick break on Weekly Outdoor Plus. Matero's Pub and Pizza in Polonia is home to York Kerr and Portage County's best fish fry and best bartender. All of their food is made from scratch, including their delicious thin crust pizzas, making any selection worth the drive. Whether it's game night, a celebration, Saturday shrimp dinner, or just a night out, come join us at Matero's, located on Highway 66, just 7 miles east of Stevens Point. Open 4 p.m. Wednesday through Sunday. For more information, go to www.materospizza.com.
Inside you, there's an outside you. A you that finds your dinner by finding your dinner's dinner. A you that isn't afraid to pick a fight with something that has a sword for a nose. This is for that you.
Hi, welcome to Frank's Hardware in Stevens Point, Wisconsin.
Proud of family owned and operated since the 1940s.
Conveniently located on Highway 10, Frank's Hardware has all your general hardware needs, and we specialize in a wide variety of products, meaning all of your paint, lawn and garden, plumbing, electrical, and many more of those household needs.
Not only do we have a new one,
but we can show you how to fix what you already have.
Did you know Frank's Hardware also offers a wide variety of services?
So stop on down to Frank's Hardware today. We don't just have great products,
but we have great service.
Receive high-quality towing and recovery services in central Wisconsin from J&K Towing. Automotive and medium-duty towing with a soft and gentle touch in caring for your vehicle put them ahead of their competition. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, interstate and intrastate. J&K Towing is a proud provider of AAA and Road America. So the next time you need a lift, call up J&K Towing, 715-335-TOWS. J&K Towing, we don't want an arm and a leg, we just want your toes.
Thank you. Real Deal Mineral. The results speak for themselves.
And now back in the blind with Mike and Jordan as she's looking to score her first Wisconsin whitetail deer for this year.
I could hardly even steer. Oh my goodness. I could hardly even steer. Oh my goodness. I had to like be way over like this.
She was bleeding good though.
I shot a little high, but. I really had to go like way over, because if you're where I am, I have to like aim way forward to.
Oh.
It's October 10th. It was my first day out hunting in Wisconsin, and I actually shot a doe the first day. We were only out for about an hour and a half-ish, so we're just looking at the blood trail, and we're gonna go and recover, hopefully.
She went this way.
Over here. I've never tracked a deer like this before either. Oh, yeah. She's doing good.
Look at the blood trail.
Oh my God. Tracked my first Wisconsin doe, and she went about 75 yards from where I shot her, and we're gonna get her all cleaned up, and we'll have some fresh venison to make. So yeah, it's actually my first doe ever that I shot.
Receive high-quality towing and recovery services in central Wisconsin from J&K Towing. Automotive and medium-duty towing with a soft and gentle touch in caring for your vehicle put them ahead of their competition. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, interstate and intrastate. J&K Towing is a proud provider of AAA and Road America. So the next time you need a lift, call up J&K Towing, 715-335-TOWS. J&K Towing, we don't want an arm and a leg, we just want your toes. Bucks and Bulls Archery in Stevens Point is now under new ownership and has a new location. Stop down to 3272 Church Street and meet the new owner, Gary Hintz. His fully stocked pro shop carries Matthews, Hoyt, and many more products to serve all your needs. They also do all repairs for any style and full customizations. Leagues and lessons will begin soon, so stop in today and check out what's new, because we're confident that we can get you from in here to out there. Bucks and Bulls Archery, Stevens Point, Wisconsin.
Optimizer by HHA Sports. The Optimizer Lite Ultra, voted number one single pin adjustable sight for 10 years running. The Optimizer Speed Dial for crossbows, to the yard accuracy with a single reticle. And the Optimizer Horizon, offering unmatched accuracy from both short and long range firearms. All Optimizer sight systems utilize range dial shoot technology. Ask for Optimizer at a dealer near you.
Hi, welcome to Frank's Hardware in Stevens Point, Wisconsin.
Proudly family owned and operated since the 1940s.
Conveniently located on Highway 10, Frank's Hardware has all your general hardware needs, and we specialize in a wide variety of products, meaning all of your paint, lawn and garden, plumbing, electrical, and many more of those household needs.
Not only do we have a new one,
but we can show you how to fix what you already have.
Did you know Frank's Hardware also offers a wide variety of services?
So stop on down to Frank's Hardware today. We don't just have great products,
but we have great service.
Hey guys, it's that time of the week again. We're going to be going over some of our fan photos. If you'd like to get involved with the show and show off some of your photos, feel free to send them to us at Weekly Outdoor Plus at live.com or message us on our Facebook page. Please also include your name and a brief description of what you've been shooting or hunting or what the picture's all about. So if you'd like to get involved in the next couple upcoming weeks, definitely send them in and hopefully we'll see some of your photos.
Our first picture this week comes from Justin Klein with an early season doe kill. And here's our good friend Linda from over at Frank's Hardware with her catch of the day. And next we have one from her husband Rick with an impressive walleye. And this one comes from 5-year-old Maverick shooting bow in his backyard. And here he is again, practicing from the elevated tree stand, getting ready so he can go hunting someday. Next up, we have Johnny and his Uncle Jeff, who went out and got these ducks one afternoon. And our next one comes from Eli, who landed this big sheephead in the Green Bay area. And our last picture this week came from Brian King of his dad on opening day with this monster Wisconsin buck.
Big thanks to the fan photos this week. If you're interested in having yours on here, again, send them via email to weeklyoutdoorplus@live.com or message format on Facebook. Stay tuned for some more Weekly Outdoor Plus action. Welcome to this week's lesson segment on Weekly Outdoor Plus, brought to you by Barbershop, 2400 Church Street, Stevens Point, where they have the most wide variety of vacuums, sewing machines, and parts you could need, and great service to go along with it. So get your... Hey guys, welcome to this week's lesson segment on Weekly Outdoor Plus. Jace Hintz here with you again, and this week we're going to go over one thing that a lot of people don't think about when they're standing in their tree stands, and it's if your tree stand is not level or you're, you know, facing a different direction, you're off balance. The biggest thing that most people are going to be screwing up on, and I've heard a lot of stories about this already, is that they're canting their bow. They can't understand why they're hitting the front shoulder when they're aiming behind it, and they can't understand why they're hitting the guts when they're aiming at the heart. And it's all simply because you might be tilting your bow depending if you're standing on a level tree, if your stand's actually level, if you're not leaning one way or the other trying to avoid something. The big thing is most of the sights come with levels on them. Make sure that you use your level if you have one. Make sure that it is level before you actually start using it as well. As long as you're always the same and consistent, you'll shoot good, obviously. But the way it works basically is if you can't your top of your bow one way like this, if I have my limb going to the right here, I will shoot the same way that my top limb is. It's gonna push the arrow that way basically. It's one way that a lot of people actually use to get rid of the wind. If there's a wind coming from your side, you actually can just lean into it and you'll be able to make a good shot and it'll go straight where you're aiming. But you gotta also play with how much you need to lean your bow, because you can go over one bubble on your level, and if you're shooting 50 yards, that could be up to 4 inches already. So make sure that you know that you're holding your bow straight up and down. Even if your tree's not level, you still need to cant your bow so it's straight up and down. Because otherwise you're gonna be shooting right and left, and you're gonna have a lot more issues when you're in the woods and even target practicing. So something to look at, go over that, see how it works for you. Make sure that, you know, if you don't have a level on your sight, think about it. Maybe you need one, or have your buddy stand behind you, make sure that you are holding it straight up and down. So as always, if you guys got any questions or would like to have us talk about anything, check us out on Facebook or check this out on YouTube if you have any other things that you'd like to see. Have a good week, guys.
Tired of buying a new vacuum every 3 to 4 years? Well, we found your solution at Barbershop, your vacuum cleaner and sewing machine headquarters.
When I decided to invest in a vacuum, I went to Barbershop.
And while you're here, take advantage of their scissor and knife sharpening services. With the knowledge to help you find that vacuum or sewing machine you're looking for, why go anywhere but 2400 Church Street in Stevens Point to Barbershop? You need parts? We have as complete of a supply of vacuum and sewing machine parts as you could find. So before you invest in a vacuum, see us, because we sell the best and fix the rest. Barbershop, 2400 Church Street, Stevens Point.
Optimizer by HHA Sports. The Optimizer Lite Ultra, voted number one single pin adjustable sight for 10 years running. The Optimizer Speed Dial for crossbows, to the yard accuracy with a single reticle. And the Optimizer Horizon, offering unmatched accuracy from both short and long range firearms. All Optimizer sight systems utilize range dial shoot technology. Ask for Optimizer at a dealer near you.
Otero's Pub and Pizza in Polonia is home to York Current, Portage County's best fish fry and best bartender. All of their food is made from scratch, including their delicious thin crust pizzas, making any selection worth the drive. Whether it's game night, a celebration, Saturday shrimp dinner, or just a night out, come join us at Otero's, located on Highway 66, just 7 miles east of Stevens Point. Open 4 p.m. Wednesday through Sunday. For more information, go to www.materospizza.com. Looking for some family fun this fall? Check out Trebatowski's Corn Maze just off Highway 54, minutes east of Stevens Point. This 18-plus acre corn maze is now open every Saturday and Sunday from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. until October 26th. And while you're here, also enjoy the Petting Zoo Farmyard, Pumpkin Patch, Hay Rides, Pig Races, Scavenger Hunt, and the Sunken Ship Play Area right next to the concession stand. So get outdoors more this fall at Trebatowski's Corn Maze on Highway BB, just off Highway 54 East. For more information, check out TrebCornMaze.com.
This mineral is a game changer. I've put the odds in my favor. It's time to close the deal. I wouldn't change a thing. Finally, the buck of a lifetime. Real Deal Mineral, the results speak for themselves.
Looking for a fun, state-of-the-art facility to shoot your bow this winter? Blackhawk Archers in Polonia, Wisconsin wants you to join their club. Located just 15 minutes east of Stevens Point on County Road Z, Blackhawk Archers has a heated indoor range for both 3D and spot target shooters. Leagues will be forming soon, and they also will have open shoots for the public this winter. Check out blackhawkarchers.net to stay up to date and for more information. Or stop into Bucks and Bulls Archery in Stevens Point for membership forms. We'll see you there. And now we end today's show with an exciting Wisconsin youth hunt down in Vernon County with our good friend Al Huckey, who took out 12-year-old Mitchell Steckel this year and hopes to bag a Wisconsin buck.
Small. nice shot. It's beautiful.
Watching some raccoons come down some trees. Two raccoons come down a tree, and all of a sudden you say, there's a buck, and he comes about 20 yards past the raccoons. He's just eating acorns, and finally got a shot at him. I blasted him.
Where'd you hit him?
Right in the heart.
Nice buck.
Thanks.
That's what, 7:30 in the morning? Mm. Right away in the stand for about what, an hour?
Probably.
Yeah. Beautiful morning.
Mitchell, you only went 10 feet.
Thank you for watching this week's episode of Weekly Outdoor Plus presented by Bucks and Bulls Archery in Stevens Point, Wisconsin. Don't forget to check us out online at facebook.com/weeklyoutdoorplus. See you next week.